Hey, Cancer. So happy birthday. Happy summertime. So we are about to get into the summer readings. These are going to be by sign. I'm not going to do them by element this time because the way things worked out last time, I feel like I can get more done this way. Either way, let's go ahead and get into it to see what it is that spirit wants to share with you over this summer season, okay? What it is that you can look forward to, expect, what guidance, what insight it is that is going to support you at this time. All right, so we are going to do this reading a little differently. First, we're going to roll some dice. So when I was sitting with your energy, all right, when I was sitting with your energy, I was getting what's that song? Summertime by Beyonce and Jay-Z kept coming up. And I was like, okay, so Cancer, you may be having a very romantic, very passionate, very soul connective kind of summer. You have here Taurus, Pluto and Taurus in the eighth house. Now, I will read this in the way in which it has rolled out, but we're going to pull cards for each planet sign in house, right? But with this is a very deep connection, very loving thing. It could be bring some power struggles in a sense, but it doesn't feel that way. It feels like things are really transforming in your possessions, how it is that you bring in finances, okay, in your love life, in your intimate life, in even in your sexual life, you know, in having what it is that you have been desiring in a way that you feel very passionate and committed to, you know, in really embracing the change it is that is here for you, you know, really transforming your sense of self-worth and value in regards to how it is that you feel about yourself within your relationships, right? But also in regards to how it is that you are feeling when it comes to your resources and what it is that you have and what you share with others, right? So there, you may be moving this summer, okay? You may be moving in with a significant other if you are single. If you are with someone, you and your significant other may just be moving, you know, and really taking time to move forward in commitment, in honoring yourself and one another together, right? There could even be some there could be some children coming about as well, or a pregnancy. How did this get in there? Maybe a pregnancy coming as well. Let's see. And a lot of deep soul transformation, karmic things that are being moved beyond and bypassed. Not necessarily bypassed, but healed in a way that is really offering you a sense of reprieve. Now, some of you may be in a space of needing to change an aspect that has been very stuck, very stagnant in a sense, right? That is going to support you and allow you to be in a space of rest, of peace, you know, and letting go of anything that has come from the past, really healing karma in regards to relationships, right? So let's see. Spirit. Okay, so the first card that we have here is the Mother of Baskets. In the Mother of Baskets, this is about nurturing. This is about love and unconditional love and compassion, you know, and also really tapped into your intuition, especially in regards to where it is that you're building, what it is that you are building a foundation in regards to, you know, and really taking your time to see the bigger picture and see it in a way that is very loving, right? And that really supports you in being able to see the world in its fullness, others in their fullness, right? And understanding what it is that is truly being offered to you, right? But also what it is that you have to share, what it is that you have to give, right? But you have a lot of new things coming in for you during this summertime, especially in regards to love, especially in regards to the things it is that you have. And what it is that you really love, what you really want and desire is coming, right? And you are moving forward into this Four of Knives energy, just resting, being at peace, not worrying about commotion or creating stories or narratives, breaking out of any type of, again, karmic patterns that have presented loss, right? Because what you're building is something very long term. And then you got the Three of Baskets here, having very loving, very stable, very harmonious love relationships, even in regards to your money, feeling like, you know, you have everything it is that you need and more, right? And really moving forward in a way that is going to serve you very deeply, very, very deeply. You are almost in a sense feeling like you have, like, I don't want to say that you made it, but you really have something to celebrate here. So, you know, really feeling the love. Okay. I do want to say it could be a possibility that your relationships, some of your intimate relationships could be taking a turn for a change, that like people may be leaving in a sense. Things just may be changing. People who you have really had a lot of love for, it's just time to transform those relationships in a way that is, it may not even be that they're leaving. The relationship itself may just need to change, right? And grow, right? And come to a higher level of expression, kind of, especially if it's relationships that kind of have a lot of gossip going on in them, right? But there is also recognizing where either you or other people in your life may be showing up in regards to having like some hidden agenda, and you're feeling like they're not being fully honest with you. And if that's the case, talk about it, ask, open up, see what the truth is in it. But if you don't care, you know, hey, let it be. So this fairy card, overindulgence, came out. So it's really important that you get grounded within yourself so that you can see the inner light within you. This summertime is really all about following your intuition, all right? And making sure that you're very solid, very grounded within you, within who it is that you are, okay? Don't do things out of, or get out of the space of doing things out of trying to escape of what it is that needs to be done, right? Out of just, you know, if you're hiding from something, if you're trying to dim your light in any way, if there is anything that you are participating in that's dimming your light and not allowing you to show up fully, it's time for you to move beyond that and really get into a space that allows you to do what it is that is for you to do, and that is change that is needing to be made within yourself, right? So there may be some sense, so you may, any type of possessiveness within yourself that you've been holding on to as well in regards to your relationships, is definitely time that is transforming as well. That's kind of like it's dead. It's like you can't continue to try to force a thing in anything, right? So this is not just in relationships with people. This is relationships with work. This is relationships with money, with the things it is that you have, right? This is relationships that you build when you go apply for a loan or things of that nature, right? But also relationships, like if you are dealing with any kind of habits or anything of that nature. So we have here Oceanus, the number 12, right? And he says, following your heart with enduring hard work creates success, right? So this is basically speaking about attainment. What it is that you desire is here, it's happening, it's coming. This summertime is really blessing you with what it is that you desire. It says, Oceanus, who gave birth to all the seas, rivers, springs, and wells, predicts that a heartfelt wish or project you have been aiming to achieve will finally gush out into the open. Your life will become the ideal you desire. People or objects that you have been lacking will flow your way and become the essence of your world's formation. You're far more successful than you realize. You have every chance of rising to become a star because Oceanus created all but one star. Peace of mind and enjoyment will reflect the effort spent achieving your aim. Reach for the stars because you really can bring out the heavenly manifestation of what appears to be impossible, right? So what it is that you are building, what you desire within your world, in your life, it's possible. You just have to put the work in, you know, get out of that space of being too kind of caught up and lost in any type of illusions that are, or just how, whatever decisions it is that you need to make, it's time to make them. You know, it's time to be in your authority and recognize that when you do that, when you stand up in that, the people who it is that are needed to support you in that will show up, right? And that even may also change your relationships with the people who are also, who are already in them as well. Are already there, you know, they may grow, they may leave, however it may be, but definitely there are some people who are coming forward, some new people coming forward in your life, okay? There will be some things that need to be sacrificed, but you, it's time for you to surrender to what it is that needs to be done. In whatever ways that you are overindulging, it's time to sacrifice that. So for the greater good of you, right? Because you have here tektite, and tektite asks you to raise your vibration. When gravity feels extra heavy and it's time to initiate launch sequence and blast off, when you're bored with earth life and want to expand your intergalactic horizons, okay? So take the time it is that you need to do what it needs to be done in order for you to elevate yourself, for you to expand yourself, for you to really feel in your body as well, you know, and be able to see things from a higher perspective so that you can grasp everything fully for what it is and not try to make up anything that that is not necessarily the case, right? And not really, because it says who needs it. I hail from the star in Orion's belt, people, and those currently overburdened with resentments. So what are you resenting? Why are you still holding on things from the past? It's important to let it go. Whatever it is that you didn't do or that you wish you should have done differently, go ahead and let that go. So in your relationships for this summer, benefit of the doubt. So offer people the benefit of the doubt. You know, believe in the basic goodness of other people. Give them a chance to show it. If they prove you wrong, that's on them. At least you can go to sleep knowing that you practice trust and forgiveness rather than fear and doubt. And later on, if I need to, you can always change your mind and retroactively judge them like it's your career. Okay, so definitely take some time to offer people the benefit of the doubt before you go about making up accusations about how it is that you believe that they may be showing up when that may not necessarily be the case. Okay, so let's see. Spirit, what else is here for Cancer? For this summertime energy, Cancer, and forgiveness. All right, so forgive others, forgive yourself. All right, take time and tap into that superpower and let things be as they may, accept things for what they have become, what they are, all right? And definitely know that compassion goes a long way, right? And more so for yourself than anything else, because this is coming out under that energy of you. Whereas the benefit of the doubt card comes out under the energy of the relationships, the connections with other people, okay? And so definitely find gratitude in what it is that you're experiencing, and not instead of being in a space of resentment of what could have been done differently or how another person showed up or however that may be, you know, or in regards to whatever dealings it is that you've had up until this time, okay? So take the time to nurture yourself, to love on yourself, to accept yourself for who it is that you are, right? We are all growing. We are all learning ourselves fully through all aspects of our life, right? All experiences come here to be our teacher. They are not presented to blame or however, you know, it's important that we understand that we are all flowing through seasons, right? Cycles. And it's simply up to us to really be able to recognize that and embrace that so that we can get the fullness out of what it is that's being offered to us. The times where it's difficult for you to really recognize what it is that is going on, definitely take time to get still within yourself, within your mind, so that you can see what needs to be worked through, what needs to be changed. Connect with your inner light, tap into your inner wisdom as well, and recognize what needs to be surrendered to, what needs to be let go of, so things can flow, so you can be in the flow. Don't try to control everything. Right. And then this last card you have here is patience. And it says, stop letting other people stand in your way. Okay. So the crystal with this card, the box, 1 second. Okay. So this is the moonstone. So one, you have the tektite here, which asks you to raise your vibration. And the moonstone, this is about going within, right? This is about tapping into that intuition, that higher self energy, that also that creative energy, that sacral chakra. Recognize where it is that you have been disconnected from that so that you can reconnect with that innocent nature within yourself, that active nature within yourself, so that you can reconnect with your passion, right? And take your time with everything. Stop letting other people stand in your way. So any type of experiences that you've had, any type of relationships it is that didn't go the way in which it is that you desire, or people that you just have to deal with in trying to get from point A to point B, know that you have the power to move and push through all things, okay? And definitely take the time to see it all, see it fully. Okay, Cancer, I hope that this is helpful for you. I feel that you are going to have a really beautiful summertime. There are always things that we're going to have to go through, going to have to experience. But all in all, it's definitely going to be very loving, very nourishing, very transformative, and very really touching within the depths of who it is that you are. So I hope that, you know what? I'm not finished. I have other cards to pull. What am I doing? I'm sorry, Cancer. I was trying to get through this. I was supposed to pull these first. Okay, so let's see what we have here. So we have Capricorn. Do the work. All right. Don't be lazy about it. Be optimistic that things are working out in your favor. Okay, be patient. Be methodical, be practical in the steps it is that you need to take, of what it is that you need to do, okay? And know that everything is working out in your favor, all right? Let's see what else this is. What else? Cancer. So Amethyst, tap into this, the Eight of Onks, tap into that crown chakra energy. You have the ability to really access a lot of information. Let those downloads come through. Really let it fill you up so that you can fully see, again, everything for what it is. You know, let that God essence come and flow through you so that you can have what it is that you need, not just on a physical level, but also on a spiritual level, to support you in moving through everything. You know, you're very protected and God got you. Perhaps you are connecting with a Capricorn or let's see, maybe even a Pisces as well. Yeah, a lot of Pisces energy here, Virgo energy as well. What else is here for Cancer spirit? Yeah, you got the tree. So a summer, a season of good health, all right? Fulfillments of your highest hopes. What it is that you have been desiring is coming through. Very strong roots. You know, the sun is here. The sun is out, all right? Tap into your soul. Focus on your home. Take care of home. Keep it, you know, keep it up. Keep it clean. Smudge it on a regular basis. Maybe you need to do some home cleansing when the season changes on the 21st. But again, Cancer, I hope that this was helpful for you. If so, let me know in the comments. I would love to hear what you have to say. Maybe some of these things are already beginning to take place for you. And yes, I will see you guys in the fall. All right. Bye.